Hey, Angela Langlotz, trademark attorney here, going live as I do every day to talk about trademarks, every weekday, I should say. I'm off on Saturday and Sunday. So today I'd like to talk about generic trademarks. It's a question I get a lot, often in the context of how can an ordinary word serve as a trademark, which is not really the right question, but it's kind of a related question. So let's tell a story. Let's suppose that you had a fruit cart and you sold apples, right? Could you